besties. Today I'm here doing a Cinderella inspired dress and seeing if I can do a better job than when I made this the first time. What I really loved about the live action Cinderella dress was all the petticoats with over 300 yards of ruffles, so I made sure to include that in mine. And after doing all of those ruffles, we needed a corgi break. To make this dress my own, I decided to do an ombre skirt by dyeing the top four layers from a light blue to a royal blue. Overall, there are 10 layers of skirts in this dress, and this is the final look. You'll have to come back for part two, but I promise it's worth it. Hey besties, this is part two of the Cinderella inspired dress, and if you're just joining us, this is where we left off. So today we're gonna start working on the bodice. Now, because I like the ombre on the skirt so much, I decided to do the ombre on the bodice as well by hand dyeing all the bias tape for the boning channels. And then of course we had our corgi break. I ended up lining the whole bodice in a beige fabric to really match the skin tone of the model. I then stuck in some A cups, and this is the final look. I had the super unique opportunity to photograph this on horseback. Overall, I had a blast doing this project, and I hope you guys really love how this dress came out.